rather fight than switch. Some of us would rather fight than just trust God. And as we close, not only do you stand up and fight when you're to trust the Lord, but you do the very unthinkable. Just give me a couple of minutes, Sister James. You do the unthinkable. They come and arrest Jesus, and they take him to Caiaphas. Caiaphas sends him to Pilate. Jesus has five trials on the night that he was arrested, and all five of them was illegal. Because it was illegal for them to hold court at night. But Jesus had to go. They couldn't wait till morning because they feared that the masses of people would get stirred up. So they want him tried, convicted, and sentenced before dawn. And so they tries him illegally in their kangaroo court at night. And so they take Jesus to Caiaphas, the high priest. And the Bible says that Peter follows from a distance. Verse 58. But Peter followed him at a distance to the high priest's courtyard. And he went in and sat with the servants to see the end. Peter thought it was all over. When you don't understand the significance of the cross and the power of the resurrection, then you follow from a distance. And you conclude when things go bad that all is lost, that it's over. And you throw in the towel before the game is over. And so Peter is following from a distance because he really believes that all is lost, that all of the hopes and all the dreams that they had for Jesus, for his movement, for his kingdom, that it's all lost now because Jesus has been arrested. He's going to be tried, sentenced, and crucified. And so he follows from a distance. But not only do you follow from a distance, you do the unthinkable, the unimaginable. You curse the one that you vowed to defend. Remember Peter with Jesus? Lord, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. Though all men leave you, Lord, I will die for you. But when Peter's own neck was on the line, he was warming himself with the enemies of God. And a little girl saw him there and she says, aren't you one of Jesus' disciples? And Peter said, I don't know the fella. I don't know the man. And someone else said, surely we saw you with that Galilean. And Peter says, I don't know the man. And finally one of them said, you're one of those Galileans because you talk just like the rest of those people from the west side. You are one of them. Your speech betrays you. We can tell by your slang. We can tell by your accent. And the Bible said Peter started to swear and to curse and say, I don't know the blankety blank, blankety blank. I don't know the man. When you don't understand the significance of the cross or the power of the resurrection, you will do the unthinkable, the unimaginable. You will deny the one that you vowed to die for. You're denying with your lifestyle. You're denying with your speech. You are denying with the way you treat other people. Because the only thing that keeps your mind girded and keeps you focused, it is understanding the significance of the cross and the power of the resurrection. But there's something about the Lord, though. Even when you deny him with your lips, if you really know him, if you've really been born again, then your heart just won't let you deny him. And so the Bible says that after Peter denied him for the third time, that the rooster crowed, and then Peter remembered what Jesus said, before the cock crows, you deny me three times. And the Bible says Peter was overcome with emotion and contrition, and he wept uncontrollably. He wept bitterly over his sin and over his denial of the Son of God. Even when your lips deny him, and when your actions deny him, and your behavior deny him, if you really know him, your heart will keep you in check. And your heart will convict you. And your heart will move you to brokenness and tears. And your heart will move you to repentance. And you cry out, Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner. Even when your lips and your actions and your behavior is denying him, your heart is testifying, but I really love him. And I know that he loves me. Well, even if you don't understand the significance of the cross, And even if you don't understand the power of the resurrection, if you know the Lord, he'll find you. He'll pick you up. He'll set your feet back on a solid rock. Remember in John 21? Jesus had already appeared to them on two occasions. But they didn't really understand what it meant. It was kind of mystical, and he was talking in riddles, and they couldn't really figure out what he was saying. So they didn't know if he was coming back to take them with him, or was he going to leave them, or what. And finally, Peter just got frustrated about the whole thing. He was here. He came through walls and stuff. Now he's gone. Where is he? So in John 21, Peter was thinking about what he was going to do. And Jesus had came and left him. And then in John 21, verse 3, Peter said, I'm going fishing. Lord left us, he's gone. I'm going back to fishing. Yeah. He still didn't understand the significance of the cross or the power of the resurrection. And when you don't understand that, what you will end up doing is going back to your old ways. Your old ways of doing things, the old places you hung out with, the old crowd that you hung around with, because things don't happen the way you think they ought to happen. And so Peter decided, I'm just going to go back fishing. Went and got his fishing tackle, his nets, and went back out on the Sea of Galilee. And because he was the leader, the other disciples says, we're going too. And so like a bunch of little ducks, they followed Peter out on the lake. And Jesus was watching them. And he let them fish all night. And they didn't even get a bite. All night, they fished all night long and didn't catch a single minnow. And then Jesus hollered from the seashore, hey, children, you caught anything? Drop your nets down on the right side. On the right side. You got to be on the right side of the Lord. And so they dropped the nets down on the right side, and the book says this fish came and jumped in the net. And Peter had experienced this before. He knew it was the Lord, because only the Lord could make fish obey. And the Bible says Peter put his garment back on and he jumped in the water as if to say, I'm not out here fishing, I'm just taking a swim. And so he jumps in the water. And Jesus says, bring yourselves on here. And the Lord had prepared a fire there on the Galilean bank. And the coals on the fire were burning. And you remember Simon Peter warmed himself by the coals of fire on that night that Jesus was betrayed to be crucified. And I've been told that the sense of smell is the sense that creates the most vivid sensation in our mind of recreating an experience. Your eyes might fool you. Your ears might become dull. But what you smell, you smell. And you remember that, and your mind remembers that. And so now Peter comes beside the fire, and he smells these coals. Yeah. And his mind is taken back on that night. Yes. He betrayed Jesus. He denied him when he should have stood up for him and testified. All right. And so the Bible says that they're having breakfast by the seashore. And then Jesus says to Simon Peter, up to this point, he's appeared to them twice, but he really hasn't talked directly to Peter. Peter hadn't brought it up either. Peter hadn't brought up anything about me betraying you and cursing you and denying you. Peter hadn't brought it up. The Lord hadn't brought it up. Peter said, hey, well, it's all forgotten. I'm not going to worry about it. See, some of us try to live our Christian life like that. So the Lord brings him by the fire. And the Lord says to Peter, he says, Simon, verse 15, son of Jonah, do you love me? Peter gets a bit uncomfortable. That's a tough question. And the term that Jesus used there for love comes from the word agapeo, agape. To love with a love that says, I'm willing to sacrifice for your highest good. Simon, do you love me enough you're willing to sacrifice for my highest good? And Peter says to him, Lord, you know that I love you. But Peter changed up on him. Peter used the word phileo, which means brotherly love. He said, Lord, you know that I love you like a brother. I'm not sure if I'm willing to die for you because you know I denied you, but I love you as much as I love a brother. Jesus says, well, then feed my lamb.